Coinsilium. I'm joined by Eddy Travia. Eddy, good to see you. Good morning.
Yes, nice to see you, Andrew. Good morning to you.
I spot your recent newsletter, Eddy. You've been updating on IOV Labs and TerraStream. Just bring us up to date on how these investee companies are doing.
Yes, so for IOV Labs, it's one of our first investees. They manage the sidechain called RSK, so it's a very important one for us. And now we also associated with us collaborating in Asia through a joint venture, which we're working out the terms right now. And the update was about that, explaining that we have announced the joint venture earlier at the beginning of the year, but because of the current unprecedented times, it has been a little bit delayed. Physically, I'm not in Singapore. I'm in China at home, like most, almost everyone these days. But at the same time, I'm working from here, and the IOV Labs team is very working and is working. But we are progressing. Just the joint venture itself is not clearly finalized yet.
What about the joint venture with TerraStream?
Yeah, so this is also a collaboration effort. We are basically working with a development company that is both working in Gibraltar, where our chairman Malcolm Pally is located, and also in Prague, in Czech Republic. And so this this joint venture and this association is working on new projects and meant to build blockchain solutions for TerraStream blockchain solution clients. And that has already started. They're already working on one project right now.
Well, look, clearly you and I, Eddy, we're talking on Zoom at the moment. Coinsilium, yourself, Malcolm, no strangers to remote working. But what's the impact do you feel from this this new push towards digital? What does that mean for blockchain and crypto?
Yes, I think it's quite important. I think this the fact that everybody is working from home now, most of the world population actually, means that people are looking at technology in a different way. And I think blockchain technology is really seen now as an enabler. And it's, everybody sees the power of the internet, the fact that so much business can be done now through the internet. And of course, blockchain technology uses and is built on top of the internet, but a lot of applications can be built on blockchain. And I think people will realize that, of course, there is a shift to remote work, and there's also a massive shift to e-commerce and electronic payments, as people cannot go into shops or physically meet other people for transacting. So we see really this internet of value movement that we have been talking about for the last few years in blockchain. Going to see the world taking more conscious about that and really understanding the power of this. So accelerating the pace businesses and individuals will adopt these technologies, in my opinion.
When you're talking about e-commerce and doing business online, of course, you've got an investment in a firm, Indorse, who focus on skills verification, Eddy.
Yes, so we have invested in 2017 in Indorse, and Indorse has pivoted into a company that is now assessing coding skills of a lot of very large companies, Fortune 500 companies. And I believe that is extremely appropriate today when a lot of people are working from home and technology is even more essential to the way, you know, we do business and we live. So this is why I've asked Gorang Torvekar to actually join us in this conversation and tell us more about Indorse, which started off in Singapore, but actually has offices in London now as well, where Gorang is located.
Well, Gorang is indeed with us, and good to see you. Look, tell us a little bit about, a bit more about Indorse and how the growth plans are coming along.
Sure. Thanks, Eddy, and thanks, Andrew, for the great introduction. So, Indorse, we started back in 2017, and we did an ICO at that time, raised about $9 million in Singapore. After that, we have actually focused heavily on getting customers and generating revenue as a company. So over the last year or so, we have been generating more than $1 million in revenue book, and we have worked with several enterprise clients. So just to give you a short introduction about Indorse. So the core of Indorse is the coding assessment platform. So using Indorse, you can actually conduct code reviews and code evaluations on your candidates when you're hiring software developers. But based on that core engine, we have two lines of services, or two verticals, that's what you can call it. One is online hackathons. So using these online hackathons, you can hire in a massive fashion, completely online. So you must know about hackathons, which are conducted physically, where you lock people in a room for 2 days, which you can't really do right now, you know. And hence, I think online hackathons are a great way going forward. Companies can hire, hundreds of developers online with this. And the second part is about upskilling. So, when you have a shortage of developers, shortage of tech talent, you can either hire them or you can either develop that talent internally within your company. So we also do upskilling, based on the blockchain assessments and all those things. Yeah, that's a short intro about Indorse. And I think, in these times of remote working, we are becoming quite relevant, and the services offered by Indorse are quite relevant in these times, definitely.
And you are working with some Fortune 500 companies now, are you?
Yep, exactly.
And a strong pipeline of new potential clients?
Yeah, definitely. So in London, we are actually talking to a couple of enterprise companies as well. And I think the contract should be signed in a month or two. And I hope we continue getting this business this year, looking at the environment.
Indeed, because it was it mid last year, I believe, that you got the investment to really push and expand into India?
Yes, exactly. So we also got an investment from Times of India. They invested about $2 million in Indorse. That we used for actually building our brand in India. So that's on the horizon this year, for expansion into Europe, India. That's what we're going to do this year.
Very good. Well, Eddy, if I can bring you back in here, it sounds as though some good progress being made at Indorse. You must be pleased here.
Yes, we're very pleased by the work that Gorang and his team have been doing. I mean, they... Gorang is being maybe a little bit modest, but yes, he works with very big names, banks, and very large companies here, and I think they have made really, really good progress. Just for the viewers, we have invested in Indorse about $450,000, and that corresponds today to about 10% of the company. But when Times of India came in, we saw a nice increase of the value of the company, and we look forward to be able to crystallize this at some point.
Which is a final comment then, Eddy, as far as the near term and your investors who are watching this now, how nervous are you about some of the uncertainty that's out there?
Well, I guess personally, I'm in a bit of a different position because, I'm in China and all this started in January. So I'm already a bit, if I may, on the other side of the tunnel, and life is basically normal here, just people wearing masks all around. So I'm a bit more optimistic in that sense. I see a lot of opportunities, really. I mean, the good thing is that for us, when the crypto market becomes more active, more volume, and there is more interest, there is always more interest in what we do at Coinsilium. I mean, of course, we have crypto assets, we have Bitcoin, but that's only a small part of the story. I mean, we have always been building along with companies that really believe in blockchain and decentralization. And for example, the central banks of the world, namely the ones that are really public about it, are the Chinese one, the South Korean one, and the French one, are really looking at what we call CBDCs, central bank digital currencies. And some of our investees, for example, IOV Labs, are already working with banks in Latin America. So I think there are a lot of opportunities in terms of working with large organizations and governments. And always when there is movement around crypto, people look at it in a different way. And I think we're about to enter in a new wave of high interest for cryptocurrency assets and blockchain in general.
Interesting. Eddy, Garang, thanks indeed both for your time. Nice to see you.
No, thank you, Andrew.
Thank you very much.
Have a nice
day. Thank you, Andrew.